Hello everyone, so far we have studied the derivative of simple function like sine x, e raised to x, root x, etc. But how about the derivative of sine root x, e raised to tan x, root of cos x, etc. These are known as composite function. So, in this section, let's study how to differentiate composite function. Now, in general, let's consider a composite function, that is y is equal to f of g of x. Now, the question is why it is composite function. So, it's very simple. In general, the function is denoted by f of x. In this, x is replaced by some new function, that is g of x, and that is why it becomes a composite. In simple language, isko main assume karta hun, y is equal to f of box. Box means your new function. Now, I want to differentiate y with respect to x. So, let's apply derivative in the left hand side. So it will be dy upon dx. Now in right hand side, how to work? So it's very simple. Sabse bahar ka function hai f. To aap f mein derivative apply kar do. Aur is box means g of x ko as it is rakho. Into derivative of that box. Now, in the next step, हमको सिर्फ derivative निकालना है इस box का, means g of x का. So, in the next line, we will get dy upon dx is equal to f dash of g of x into g dash x. Now, we will take one example, that is y is equal to sine of e raised to x. First of all, we are going to see why this sine e raised to x is composite function. So in standard form, sine kaise dikhai deta hai? Sine of x. Is x ko humne replace kiya hai by a new function, that is e raised to x. To is x ko hum hatayenge aur replace karenge usko e raised to x se. So we will get a function like sine of e raised to x. तो बाहर पहला function है sine और उसके अंदर दूसरा function आ गया e raised to x. So that is why it is a composite function. Now, in a simple language, we can say that y is nothing but sine, which is acting as a f of e raised to x, which is acting as g of x. तो आपका y किस form में हो गया? F of g of x. So, this is a composite function. Now, we have to differentiate y with respect to x. So, in a left hand side, we are going to apply derivative. So, it will be dy upon dx equals to. You know that derivative of sin x is nothing but cos x. So, आपको मैंने पहले बताया था कि बाहर वाला जो भी function है, आप उसको differentiate कर दो. तो sin का derivative क्या होता है? Cos. अब x नहीं रहेगा. X की जगह पे आपका जो new function था, जो आपका g of x था, that will come as it is. Into derivative of that box means that new function. That is e raised to x. Now e raised to x is your g of x, which is in standard form. You know that derivative of e raised to x is nothing but e raised to x only. That is why derivative of e raised to x will come e raised to x. So in the final answer we'll say that dy upon dx is equal to cos of e raised to x into e raised to
एक्स। आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू।
नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम फॉर्मूले ऑफ डेरिवेटिव ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड कंपोजिट फंक्शन। सो हियर वी मेड टू कॉलम्स। इन फर्स्ट वन आई हैव टेकन अ कंपोजिट फंक्शन विच इज y इज इक्वल टू एफ ऑफ जी ऑफ एक्स, एंड सेकेंड कॉलम इज इट्स डेरिवेटिव, दैट इज dy अपॉन dx इज इक्वल टू एफ डैश ऑफ जी ऑफ एक्स इंटू डेरीवेटिव ऑफ जी ऑफ एक्स। सपोज आई एम टेकिंग फर्स्ट फंक्शन दैट इज साइन ऑफ जी ऑफ एक्स। सो जी ऑफ एक्स इज योर बॉक्स, दैट इज योर न्यू फंक्शन। सो इट्स डेरीवेटिव विल बी, साइन का डेरीवेटिव इज कॉस, सो दैट वी हैव रिटन कॉस ऑफ जी ऑफ एक्स इंटू द डेरीवेटिव ऑफ दैट जी ऑफ एक्स। सेकेंड वन इज cos of g of x. So the derivative of cos is minus sine of g of x into the derivative of g of x. Third one is tan of g of x. You all know that the derivative of tan is sec square. That is why sec square of g of x into the derivative of g of x. Fourth one is cot of g of x. So you all know that the derivative of cot is minus cosec square. That is why minus cosec square of g of x into the derivative of g of x. Fifth one is sec of g of x. So you all know that the derivative of sec is sec into tan, and that is why sec of g of x into tan of g of x into the derivative of g of x. Sixth one is cosec of g of x. You all know that the derivative of cosec is minus cosec into cot. That is why minus cosec of g of x into cot of g of x into derivative of g of x. Seventh one is e raised to g of x. So we all know that the derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x only, and that is why e raised to g x will become e raised to g of x into the derivative of g of x. Eighth one is a raised to g of x, where a is a number greater than 1. So we all know that the derivative of a raised to x is a raised to x into log a. That is why the derivative of a raised to gx will be a raised to g of x into log of a into the derivative of g of x. Ninth one is log of g of x. So we know that the derivative of log x is 1 upon x, and that is why the derivative of log of g of x will be 1 upon g of x into the derivative of g of x. Tenth one is g of x raised to n. So we all know that the derivative of x raised to n is n x raised to n minus 1. That is why the derivative of g of x raised to n is n g of x raised to n minus 1 into the derivative of g of x. These are the 10 formulas of derivative of standard composite function. Now we are going to solve some question based on this composite function. First question is y is equal to tan of cos of sin x. In this, cos sin x is a box, that is g of x, and tan
is your first function, that is f. That is why this is in the form of f of g of x, which is a composite function. Now we have to differentiate y with respect to x. So left hand side will be dy by dx, and you know that derivative of tan is sec square, and this box will remain as it is into the derivative of this box. Now the second part, that is cos of sin x, we have to differentiate, but we cannot differentiate directly because it is not a standard function. Why? Because हमारे पास फंक्शन होता है cos of x, but यहाँ पर cos of sin x है. That is why this sin x is again acting as a box, that is g of x, and बाहर का जो फंक्शन है that is acting as a f. So again here we have a composite function, that is f of g of x. So the next step will be dy by dx is equal to this total term remain as it is into, you know that the derivative of cos is minus sign, and that is why it is minus sign of box, that is sin x, into the derivative of this box. Since sin x is a standard function, so easily we can differentiate. So next step will be dy by dx is equal to your first part will remain as it is, second part also remain as it is, and the last part sin x has a derivative cos x. So this one will be your final answer. Second question is y is equal to log of log x the whole raised to 4. In this question, log of log x is acting as a box. So your y is in the form of box raised to n. Now we are going to differentiate y with respect to x. So the left hand side will be dy upon dx is equal to, since it is in the form of box raised to n, so let's apply the formula, that is 4 box raised to 4 minus 1 into the derivative of this box. Now you can observe that log of log x is not a standard function, so directly we cannot differentiate. In this log x is acting as a again a function, or you can say that a box. So let's differentiate by using composite function once again. So in left hand side we have dy by dx equals to 4 times log of log x, 4 minus 1 comes 3. Now we have to differentiate log of log x, so it is acting as log of box, and that is why we have the derivative 1 upon box into the derivative of box, means 1 upon log x into derivative of log x. Now this log x is now in a standard form, that is why we can differentiate directly. So in the next line we will get dy upon dx is equal to 4 times log of log x the whole raised to 3, 1 upon log x into 1 upon x. So this one will be your final answer.